Hey everybody, hope you're all doing well. My name is Steven and this is the Storytime Channel. We've got tales of malicious compliance and our first story of the day is by No Numbers 90. Clean as you go? Okay. Up until about 4 years ago, I worked for a large supermarket here in the UK. Night shift replenishment. We filled and rotated the shelves at night so they could just be topped up in the day. I'm going to start off by saying that cleaning standards in my store were subpar. Anyways, we all had our own designated aisles to fill. I was usually on a produce aisle, fruits and vegetables, but as times called for it, I could be taken to other areas of the store that were struggling. Now, every department has its own manager, and every manager is different. Our produce manager was on the ball, department clean and tidy at all times, paperwork always done, always back up for holidays, a tight ship. Dairy manager, on the other hand, couldn't organize a piss up in a brewery. One of the things he was very slack on was cleaning. On the surface, he would have the shelves clean, but behind the stock was a different story. The shelves are slanted, so you can only see the back of the chiller if you get down and then look directly up behind an area with no stock, so pretty much 100% hidden. So one night, Derry is struggling again due to the fact that the area is run by a chimp that the company shaved and threw a uniform on. I get sent over as produce is ahead of schedule. Yogurt aisle specifically. It's not difficult work, but as I'm filling those shelves, I get a nice view of all the mold on the back of the chillers. The chillers blow cold air from the back, so as I'm reaching my arms in, I'm short with short arms, I get a nice face full of moldy smelling air the whole darn night and again the next night. Night 3, I'm sick as a dog, can't stop vomiting amongst other things, and this goes on for 3 more nights into my weekend. I get back and I have to have my meeting with the night manager and dairy manager. Mine was on holiday. They are not happy with my absence. This was my second period in the year. Now, I had been at this store for 5 years and these 2 absences were the only sickness I had off. I'm a bit defensive and I point out the fact that I'd basically been working in a biohazard area for 2 days. I told them about the mold blowing in my face for 2 nights, which I also pointed out to the dairy manager on day 1 and was dismissed. Not good enough. Apparently, I'm only going off sick because I know the usual yogurt guy is always going sick and I'm trying to take advantage. They never did connect those dots. After all this, the outcome was a written warning. They have to send you out the room before giving you a warning to discuss, as per procedure. Thin walls, I could hear them.
He could appeal based on the moldy chillers. He has evidence. Just get him on the clean as you go policy.
And that's what they did. They said if the chillers were dirty, it's my responsibility as the policy is technically clean as you go. If you see a mess, you clean it, end of. I said that's madness. There's like 7 years of buildup there. The whole aisle has it. Didn't matter. That's the policy. Fine, so be it then. Anyway, that night I'm back on yogurts. Usual guy is actually back in, but I guess this was now some sort of weird extra punishment. But at least now I'm fully aware of that darn clean as you go policy. Another thing I haven't mentioned is not just how useless the dairy manager is, but how lazy he is. This also applies to the night manager. The night shift, to be honest, doesn't require much running. Everyone has their aisles and they know their job. The dairy manager, night manager, and grocery manager would spend the night chilling outside smoking, barely popping in to check on things. The produce manager was usually left to handle any issues as he was actually respectably professional, but he's on holiday this night. Yogurts is at the back of the store, smoking shelter is at the front. I know I'm all alone all night long, and I have a lot to clean. First things first. Have to get to the back of the chillers, all the stock is in the way. Better take it off. So all the stock piled onto cages and run into the chiller, 9 cages total. Only took me a couple of hours as it's 10 times quicker to take off as it is to put out. Shelves are still in the way, better take them down. To be honest, the back edge on the mall needs cleaning too. So all the shelves unhinged and dismantled, they just lift off and pull out. Get them all on a couple cages and run them into the warehouse so I can spray them down in the cleaning area. This took longer than expected as some of that black mold was incredibly stubborn. Better leave them here to dry. Back to the aisle, can finally start on the backs of these chillers. Again, just like the shelves, super hard to get off. Took me the rest of the night to get one side cleaned. The other, though, terribly filthy. So that's how my night ended. Nothing on the shelves, actually not even any shelves. And the managers had no idea. A few people asked me what I was doing that night. I just told them, night manager says I have to clean this. Nobody informed them. Morning comes, 6 a.m. The store manager comes in. He likes to walk the aisles first thing with the night managers. I'm just doing my shopping at this point next to the yogurts. He arrives. I'd never heard him swear before.
What the freak?
The night managers didn't have anything to say. They are supposed to run this place through the night and they didn't know a whole aisle had basically gone missing. He tore into them right there. Eventually, one of them mentioned they had seen me shopping. The store manager demanded someone grab me. He wants an explanation as to why one of his biggest selling aisles had vanished into oblivion. I round the corner.
What in the heck have you done?
I was told I had to clean this.
Who told you?
Night manager and dairy manager. They interjected.
We did not.
I have the notes from my attendance review signed by both of you, stating that I need to clean as I go.
Well, this isn't cleaning as you go.
Dismantling the aisle was the only way I had to get to the mold. That's when the store manager took a closer look at the back of those chillers. Not just a dark discoloration like he had assumed with his bad eyesight. Moldy. He went off again and pulled them both into the warehouse for round two. Cleaning the chillers is night manager's responsibility. This was inexcusable. I went back to shopping. Came in the next night to hear the fallout. They were both written up. The store manager made them stay and clean the other chiller wall, then put all the shelves back up, then put all the stock back out, plus the delivery that was also unworked from the night. All in all, 7 hours past shift end. And they still had to come in that night. I never saw any retaliation. I heard that was specifically from the store manager, not because he's a good guy, but because it wasn't worth it from a legal and career perspective. I had followed instructions and there are some pretty rigid labor laws and protections here. Not to mention a strong union. They didn't want head office to get wind of how filthy they had allowed a food chiller to get, opening up the company to all manner of fines. Clean as you go. Clean as you go is not a bad policy, unless it's only enforced after 7 years of continuous work. Could you imagine that word gets out that a store that you usually go to shop has years of mold buildup in their chillers? If you heard that, would you want to try and do some kind of legal action? Would you just never go there again? Let me know in the comments down below. Our next story is by Jimmy Efahenem. I'm docking 15 minutes off your pay. Yeah, cool. Don't mind if I go for a 15-minute stroll. This happened about 9 years ago at one of my first jobs. I was working in sales over the phone. They had this odd policy of docking your pay 15 minutes if you were even 2 minutes late. Just for context, at this job we took credit card details and the like, but as our security policy, we couldn't be alone when working. There would at least have to be 2 people at any time. There was rarely only 2 people on, so it was never really a problem. One day I had to come in earlier than usual at about 9 a.m. I walk in about 10 minutes early, go to my desk, no one else is in yet. I'm the first one in, so I put my bag down, turn on my computer, go to the kitchen, make a coffee, bring it back, then go to the toilet. I walk out to my desk at about 9:02. When I get to my desk, I see my team leader has just walked in and is visibly sweating from being outside. Australian summer, it's difficult not to. And he's still got his backpack on. He then says,
"You're late, I'm docking you 15 minutes.
Obviously, I'm immediately triggered and say I was there before him, I just went to the toilet. My bag is right there in front of you on my desk and my coffee. Fair enough if he was sitting at his computer ready to rock and roll, but he had just walked in the office. He ignored what I said and said,
"Doesn't matter, you're late."
So I'm proper pissed off. Not because of the 15 minutes, but purely because this runt literally just walked in and is saying, "I'm late." So being at work and not wanting to voice my actual thoughts and lose my job, I say, "Fine, I'll see you in 15 minutes then," and walk off to leave the office. At this point, he realizes he can't even work now because of company policy. He then says,
"No, you'll wait the 15 minutes here at your desk."
At this point, I was beyond being nice. I turned and said, "Are you gonna make me?" I didn't wait for an answer and continued off. When I came back 15 minutes later, team leader was sitting there with his manager, GM, and he had obviously only told half the story because of the reception I got.
What seems to be the problem? Team lead says you threatened him.
I then explained to him how I was there before him and he was docking my pay for being late when he was the one that was late. I've already come in earlier than usual and now I'm getting docked my pay when I did nothing wrong by the person that did. I pointed out that I had set myself up to work already, coffee made too, and insisted they check the security camera footage if he didn't believe me, which drew a look from the GM to my team leader. Anyway, they checked the security cameras, my story checked out, GM said I would get the 15 minutes anyway, as I did nothing wrong and even though I walked off, it shouldn't have happened. Team lead got the sack about 2 months later for other reasons. Not sure exactly why, I didn't really care to listen to him afterwards. That team lead just sounds like an absolute jerk. They didn't make a big scene of it, but it sounds like they really enjoyed docking you for literally no reason. How are you going to walk in, see somebody not actively at their desk at 9:02, 2 minutes after the arrival time, and go,
"You're late, 15 minutes.
Didn't try and listen to their story, didn't try and listen to their explanation. Nope, right as you walk in,
"Oh, you're not sitting at your desk, you're not properly checked in, 15 minutes.
I'd be pretty darn pissed off too. This next story is by Tar Nugget. You don't want to hear complaining? Okay, fine. This happened about a decade ago at a well-known insurance company. I was working as an agent, sales rep with PNC and life licenses, doing what all salespeople do to get by without losing their dignity and soul. Find a way to frame their sales pitch in a way that yields maximum results for the managers while making sure that your customers are well taken care of. Easy to balance the two, right? Anyways, one day, with much pomp and circumstance, the insurance company rolled out a new rating system. This was supposed to improve the accuracy and thus the profitability of the company. Wanting to see the bells and whistles, I went into the new system and started running some dummy quotes to see what the new prices looked like. It looked like a disaster for sales as the prices on average went up. As I was playing around, I found something interesting. If I moved the different options on and off in a specific pattern, I could offer the maximum coverage possible at a cost that was less than what the minimum coverage would cost the same customer. Clearly something was wrong with the new rating system, so as any responsible employee would do, I went up to my manager. "Hey boss man, I think there's something up with the new system."
"OP, I just don't want to hear about it anymore. It's your job to sell, not complain about the new system."
"But when I offer the highest coverage..."
"Yes, and it's your job to sell the highest coverage at every chance possible, no matter how expensive it is."
"Sir, yes sir." Needless to say, I broke a few sales records the next couple of months until we had an emergency all-hands meeting with the instructions to manually review all new max coverage policies until they fix a bug they had found that spit out insanely low prices if you followed a certain pattern. Apparently, the company had lost a bit of money. Oh well. On to the next loophole. OP literally went out of their way to make sure that the company did not lose money on this issue, and the boss was just frankly way too dismissive. If somebody comes to you and they have some kind of concern they want to share with you, I just think it would be in the best interest to listen to them. Even if it feels like maybe they're wasting your time with repeated messages and just the same memo over and over and trying to help the customer when it's our job to sell, 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 it would have saved them a lot of money. And our final story of the day is by Dirkus19. Enjoy all the extra paperwork. I am an accountant. My old job, which I left just a few months ago, was awful. Not because of the work or clients, but because of the owners. It was a small company, about 10 total employees and the two partners. One of the owners was the type of person that would call and scream at her husband in full view of all of us staffers. Open concept office for the smallest stuff. Dog was late being dropped off to its daycare, or her favorite shirt wasn't dry cleaned. She would give people a written warning and red mark on their employment for a spelling mistake in an email. Just petty as heck. The other owner was a cheapskate, refused to give rates unless you threatened to quit. Once, she told me that she wouldn't give me a raise because she didn't make that much when she was at the same point in her career, 30 years ago, as if inflation wasn't a thing. She would make us pay for our own meals and mandatory staff lunches. So after 4 years of that BS, I found another job and quit without notice. I took with me copies of some Excel/Word templates and such that I had made during my time there. A week later, I was served with a lawsuit for breach of contract, citing I had taken proprietary information from their server that has caused irreparable damage to their business. They wanted me to return all copies of documents that were created during my employment there. So I took that to heart. I first made their legal team agree that they would diarize all of the documents I provided so that there could be no coming back and saying I missed something, as well as a few more concessions, which I added one at a time before I would sign the agreement. What they thought was going to be a USB was two banker's boxes of printouts and handwritten notes. See, since I had been working from home for 5 months and I am a big note taker and print a lot of stuff for review, I had stacks of the stuff I was going to burn at some point. I took all of it into the lawyers personally and sat there while they scanned and listed every piece of paper I brought in. Took two paralegals 4 hours. All in all, I figure their petty little lawsuit cost them about $10,000 and gave me a pretty good laugh. I just don't know what's proprietary about Word and Excel templates. Yeah, it's kind of custom stuff that you made with the tools on job, but it doesn't cause irreparable damage, and it's not like they deleted them, they just took copies. They could have made exactly the same identical templates easily, I am sure, wherever they were. So yeah, this was very, very petty and not worth the investment they had to have put into all that legal action. But with that being said, that's all the time we have for today. So if you have a favorite story of the day, let me know which one and why in the comment section down below. But besides that, if you enjoyed the video, please consider giving the video a like and subscribe if you haven't, and turn notifications on so you'll never miss an upcoming video. No matter what you did, whether it was just watching the video or commenting, subscribing, whatever you do. Thank you all so very much for supporting me right here on the Storytime channel. Any single thing you do helps the channel grow that much more, and I appreciate the heck out of it. I hope you all have a wonderful day, and until next time, I'll be right here on the Storytime channel.